Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. We're talking about probability, and I wanted to show an example where you might have to find the probability from a chart or table. So in this one, this example, we're looking at applications for a private school, and we have people that have scored high enough to enter the school, and then we have test scores, the number of students that had test scores that were not high enough for entrance. And then over on this side, we have students that need financial aid and no financial aid assistance. No financial assistance needed, excuse me. So the first question is, what is the probability that if one student is chosen, they will have tested high enough to get into this school, but will require financial assistance? So if we're going to answer any questions about a whole group like this, we want to figure out what's the total number of students that we're looking at. So 25 plus 32 plus 42 plus 40 is 139. That's where we get our denominator, which is our entire sample space. That's all the people that were in our testing this year. And then we want to know the probability that they would have tested high enough to get into school but will require financial assistance. Well, they tested high enough but they need financial aid. That's 25 students in that block. So that's 25 out of 139. That's going to be about 18% or 0.1080 of the students that fall into that category. What's the probability that any student will not score high enough to be admitted into the school? Well, that's different because now we're saying we want to know all the students that tested but weren't testing high enough to get in. And so again, we have a total sample space of 139, but here I'm looking at all the people who did not score high enough, and that's going to be 82 people. So 82 divided by 139 is going to give me 0.590. So that's a little different. And then the next question is, what is the probability of the complement of B? And what does it mean? Well, we just found the complement of B. And that was 82 over 139 or 0.590. The complement is just to subtract this amount from B, from 1, excuse me. So 1 minus 0.590 is 0.410. This is the probability of the complement of B. And what this represents is the probability that the student will score high enough for an entrance, because B was they did not score high enough. So the complement of that would be that they did score high enough to get in. Sometimes we can use subjective judgment to decide if something is likely or not. For instance, if I flipped a coin 50 times and got 47 heads, we could say that it's not likely for that to happen, because recall that theoretically, if I flipped a coin 25 times, if I flipped it 50 times, I should get 25 heads, right? So I probably wouldn't get exactly 25, but it should be in that range. So if I'm getting 47, I could say that's definitely not in the range of what I would expect. But there is a law of large numbers, and that says that if we flip the coin enough times, we would get closer and closer to the theoretical probability. So in my particular example, the probability of my experiment, I'm saying I got 47 heads out of 50 times, and that's 94%. I went to two decimal places there. But theoretically, I should get 25 out of 50. And that would be 50%. So you can see that my experimental and my theoretical are not close. So subjectively, I would say that does not seem reasonable. Maybe I have a weighted coin. Maybe I did just get super lucky or unlucky, whichever way I wanted that to go. But we would say that this experiment is not reasonably close to the expected theoretical probability. To be reasonably close, we would want the results to be within 5% of each other. So if I got 4% or 46% or something like that, I would say, yeah, that's pretty reasonable. So we want to make those judgment calls sometimes to say, wait a minute, does this even make sense? Should we be around there, or should we be definitely higher or definitely lower? So we can use subjective reasoning on some of this judgment, but we use 5% as our cutoff typically. All right, have a great day, and I'll see you next time.